Namaste students. Yesterday we saw first two stanzas. Now today we can see the remaining stanzas. I said you this is the memory poem, so you have to learn all the four stanzas. Before entering into the third stanza, just we shall recall first and second stanza. So the first stanza, the poet he says that when he was traveling through the forest, he could see the house. It was all alone in the forest, and he could see the beauty of the nature. He thinks that the owner of the house must be far away. He might be in the village, so he won't get the knowledge of the poet who is standing there and admiring the beauty. And in the second stanza, he says that his horse think it very strange because the owner, that is the his master, has stopped in the place which is very unusual to the horse, because the woods are very dark in the evening. So the horse, it thinks it is very strange to stop there. Now we shall see the next stanza, third stanza. He gives his harness bells a shake to ask if there is some mistake. The only other sounds the sweep of easy wind and downy flake. So in this stanza, here he refers to the horse. You can see I have placed, posted the picture of the horse. He gives his harness bells a shake. He gives his harness bells a shake means here it refers to the horse. He is giving his bells a shake. You can see the belt which is tied in the neck of the horse, and you can see some bells which is tied there. So that is what the harness bells. So he is shaking his bells. And he is intimating his master, and he is asking his master to ask if there is some mistake. So the horse is asking to his master whether anything happening wrong around them, because the master has stopped in an unusual place. The only other sounds the sweep of easy wind and downy flake. We saw that it is the evening time and the woods are very dark. They couldn't hear any noise. They could hear only the sound of the wind and the downy flake. Downy flake means the snowfall. They could hear only the sound of the snowfall and the wind sound. Other than that, they couldn't hear any sound around the forest. So the horse think that something wrong is happening there. So it is questioning, it is asking its master whether anything is wrong, whether something is happening wrong. So that is what said in the third stanza. Next, last stanza. The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep and miles to go before I sleep. In this stanza, the poet says that the woods are lovely, dark and deep. So the forest, it looks very lovely. It looks beautiful. It looks dark and deep. Deep means it looks very thick. But I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep and miles to go before I sleep. But I have promises to keep. Here it resembles the responsibilities what the person has. Before in the poem we saw that I said you that through this the poet is trying to convey something. So what he is trying to convey means here. The poet, he says that he has many responsibilities in his life. So he has to do that responsibility. He has to complete the task, and he has to do the duties whichever he has. And miles to go before I sleep and miles to go before I sleep. Here, miles to go before I sleep. Here, sleep refers to the death. So before the person dies, he has to do the responsibilities whatever he has. So he has to do the duties. That is what the poet, he said here indirectly, and miles to go before I sleep. So he says that before he dies, he has some responsibilities to finish it in his life. So he has some duty to do that. So without doing that, he can't postpone such responsibilities and duties by wasting the time and admiring the nature. So he says that he can't waste his time by standing in the woods and wasting the time. So he has to move further to achieve his, complete his responsibilities and duties. So that is what said in this last stanza. You just go through this poem. You can able to understand that If you have any doubt, you just probe your question. I can clear it. Today we shall see only these poems, and tomorrow we can see the poem appreciation and what are the rhyming words and rhyme scheme is present in the stanza. Thank you.